Liberia has come a long way over the past 10 years, putting behind it the devastation that resulted from 40 years of civil war. This year, 2013, marks the 10th anniversary of the Accra Peace Accords, which brought new promise and progress to the country. This is the story of a nation's transformation. In 1989, Liberia plunged into a civil war that lasted 14 years and claimed the lives of over 150,000 people. There was a complete breakdown of law and order, and scores were displaced both inside and outside of Liberia's borders. More than 500,000 became refugees in neighboring countries. The regional West African group known as ECOWAS sought to intervene to end the conflict. On 18 August 2003, the Liberian parties signed a comprehensive peace agreement in Accra. By that agreement, the parties requested the United Nations to deploy force to Liberia under Chapter 7 of the Charter of the United Nations to support the National Transitional Government of Liberia and assist in the implementation of the agreement. On 19 September 2003, the Security Council unanimously adopted Resolution 1509, paving the way for UNMIL, a multidimensional peacekeeping force, to be sent to Liberia.
Everlasting Father, for granting our request and our prayer, in Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen. Amen.
As ECOMIL troops patrolled the streets of Monrovia and strove to rebuild public confidence and establish security, a breach that had previously divided warring factions was reopened. This marked a symbolic turning point. As scheduled, UNMIL took over peacekeeping duties from the ECOWAS forces on 1st October. Some 3,500 West African troops who had been serving with ECOMIL Vanguard Force were provisionally rehearted as United Nations peacekeepers. Liberia became the host country for the largest UN peacekeeping operation in the world at the time. Two weeks later, a national transitional government was sworn in, paving the way for a return to democracy. Still, ex-combatants and their weapons overwhelmed the streets. As a result, in December 2003, UNMIL implemented a comprehensive disarmament, demobilization, rehabilitation and reintegration DDRR program. The program saw 48 generals from various warring factions hand in their weapons. By the end of 2004, a total of over 24,000 weapons, 25,000 ammunition, and 5.8 million rounds of small arms ammunition were surrendered and destroyed. With the weapons off the streets, Liberians could now take part in vigorous campaigning as elections approached. Hundreds of thousands of Liberians, old and young, made 11 October and 8 November 2005 respectively very special days in the history of Africa's oldest republic when they flocked to more than 3,000 polling stations to cast their votes in the first democratic presidential and legislative elections since the war ended. These elections gave Liberians a chance to make a positive historic impact by electing Africa's first female president, Ellen Johnson Sirleaf. President Johnson Sirleaf now had the task of leading Liberia back to normalcy.
So help me God.
In a further bid to support reconciliation, the UN Security Council authorized in November 2006 the arrest and transfer of Charles Taylor to the Special Court for Sierra Leone should the former president return to Liberia. The Council had determined that the return of Tiller would constitute an impediment to the country's stability and a threat to its peace. In July 2006, Secretary General Kofi Annan paid a three-day visit to the country to reassure the people of the UN's continued engagement in the nation's reconstruction.
How very thankful we are for the support that you have received.
And I would like to really congratulate you on all that you have achieved.
On assuming office, President Sirleaf launched 150 days deliverables, which included restoring electricity to parts of Monrovia. On July 26, 2006, the lights were switched back on. As Africa's first female president continued to work to rebuild her country, the UN made its own history with the arrival of the first ever all-female unit in peacekeeping mission. In January 2007, the Indian Formed Police Unit made headlines around the world when the contingent arrived in Liberia. In another achievement, the Liberia National Police graduated the first class of female cadets in 2007. Signaling its increased capacity, the LNP staged night security patrols with members of the Emergency Response Unit and with United Nations police officers providing guidance and support in 2008. As Liberia progressed towards consolidated peace, the country began to receive world leaders. In May 2009, the U.S. Security Council sent U.S. Ambassador Susan Rice to Liberia. 2 months later, U.S. Secretary of State Hillary Clinton on 13 August visited the country with a message of support for the country's efforts towards peace and reconciliation. In November 2010, a team from the UN Peace Building Commission for Liberia, led by the then chair, Prince Zayed Al-Hussein, broke ground for the construction of a regional peace hub. The hub was the first of five to be constructed in Liberia to expand the influence of the rule of law in Liberia and aimed to be Liberia's one-stop shop for accessing justice. The LNP community policing campaign also helped to bring together concerned citizens with members of the Liberia National Police to help strengthen bonds and make communities safer for all. Also keen to enhance the rule of law in Liberia, ANMIL, through its quick impact projects, constructed magisterial court buildings, police stations and other infrastructure intended to shore up the rule of law in Liberia. Strengthening national security forces was also a priority. In April 2011, the new armed forces of Liberia for the first time carried out a battalion-level military maneuver, setting up its own logistics base to serve the needs of troops on the ground. The two-week exercise involving some 1,200 troops culminated into a mock battle fought at Nama in central Liberia, in which the combatants displayed all the known jungle warfare strategies and tactics. As the second democratic elections since the end of the Civil War neared, the National Elections Commission, NEC, on 23rd August 2011 conducted a referendum aimed at resolving key constitutional issues. Liberia's elections in 2011 were marked by high voter turnout and were deemed free, fair and transparent by national and international observers. With President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf re-elected and continuing peace in Liberia, many of the 140,000 Liberian refugees still in exile decided to return home after many years in exile with the support of the UN Refugee Agency, UNHCR. This included over 1,200 in 2010 and more than 1,700 in 2011. Today, ANMIL continues a transition process, gradually handing over increasing security functions to national partners. Coming full cycle in its recovery efforts, in June 2013, Liberia became a contributing country to UN peacekeeping efforts, sending 50 troops to help re-establish peace and security in Mali. It is the first time Liberia has participated in peacekeeping mission in 52 years. In spite of all of the gains since the return of peace to Liberia, the government still faces many challenges ahead, including constitutional reform, the decentralization of government, reconciliation, and achieving internationally agreed-upon development goals. Still, the 10-year anniversary of the Accra Accord is a moment to celebrate, to reflect, and to recommit to a brighter future for all Liberians.